Today on the channel, we're going to learn how to play Jamie's Crying by Van Halen. Hey everybody, welcome back. Today we're going to learn how to play Jamie's Crying by Van Halen. This is a great song off of Van Halen 1, and it showcases Eddie's abilities to write a great pop song with some really catchy guitar licks. So first of all, we're in E flat, Eddie tuned to just shy of E flat on the Van Halen records with David Lee Roth. So we're just slightly above E flat. Here's what it sounds like. So if you play along or you play to a backing track, that's kind of the tuning that you need to be in. So, all right, without further delay, let's take a look at this song. This song is pretty simple. There's a little bit of some complicated little picking riff things in here that I'll point out to you and demonstrate. But it's got about four or five key parts to the song. So let's first take a look at the way the song starts. The song starts off with a melodic guitar line that we hear in the beginning and we hear it towards the end of the song. He plays a little bit differently in the intro than he does in the outro. When we get to the outro, I'll cover it there. So the introduction starts off with this unison octave bend, and it sounds like this. Okay, so that's what we're going for. And I'm gonna play the riff for you, then I'll demonstrate. Okay, so let's take a look at that deeper. So what we're doing is on the 15th and 17th fret on the G and the B string, we're gonna bend up an octave like this. We're gonna get that unison sound. So it's got a little bit of a dissonance there until we hit the unison. Okay, so we gotta do that. One finger bends up, the ring finger bends up. I'm using my middle finger to help push, to give me support to push that up. So if you're new to bending like this, both of those fingers are bending up on that. And I put a little bit of vibrato on it. That way it sounds a little bit more in pitch and it gives a little bit more vocal tonality to it. Then we're gonna go up two frets. And then we're gonna go down three frets and then two. So it goes. Then we're gonna go back up to this 15th and 17th. Down one, down two. So what I do there is I'm on the 14th and 12th fret on the G and B string and I go. So I bend up, then back down, and then play that 13th fret, which is a G sharp. So all together we have. Okay, cool. While that's going on, he's playing a riff. Now I'm going to show you this riff. The riff that's in the verse is very similar to the riff that's in the chorus, except he adds a little bit different thing that's in the chorus. So let me show you the verse riff. Okay, the verse riff is, it's got kind of a funk jazz chord in it, and it's got a little bit of a swing. So it sounds like this. Okay, so what I'm doing there is I'm hitting a low E, and then I'm hitting. So what I'm doing there is it's kind of like a B minor chord. I'm hitting the top three strings on the second or the seventh fret. So, And I'm playing them with my ring finger, my middle finger, and my pinky. So I'm like, so. And in between that, I'm palm muting. I hit the low E, and then I put my palm on the strings to, and then, so I gotta. That's how that starts. So this is where it gets tricky. This is the rhythm part that you gotta get down. So what I'm doing there is I'm going. That's it. So think of it like that chord. I'm putting my pointer finger on the 7th fret, and I'm hitting the two middle strings, the D and the G string, on the 7th fret, which creates this chord. Really cool metal chord. So there's a little thing in the middle of these two chords. So the first one goes, then the second one goes. But in between that, we have to kind of do this little string scrape. I'm going. So I'm holding my hand across the strings and giving a little bit of a rake. So try to get that down. And sometimes they go. And then another scrape. And then that part goes 7-6-5-3. So I'm going. Then that same riff. I put a little bit of a vibrato on there. Makes it kind of sexy, kind of groovy. And I'm sliding up sometimes. That makes it a little bit more slinky and sexy too. And sometimes Eddie will go. He'll put that little chord in there. Sounds like Helter Skelter. So. What I'm doing there is, it's basically a D chord. It's a D sus 2. So I've got the same two middle fingers on the middle strings on the 7th. And I'm going to add my pointer finger to the 5th fret on the B string. What makes it sound like this. So. And I'm hitting that open E also. See, no rhyme or reason how or when he does that. So don't focus on how did Eddie do it exactly every single time in the song, because Eddie wasn't worried about that. Eddie was more worried about the groove and the way that this felt when he was playing it. It's just gotta keep that rhythm churning and that groove going, because he's gotta be in the pocket with Mike and Al, okay? Cool. All right, so there's a turnaround riff. This is one of the other main riffs in the song, and it comes around, I think, twice during the song, and it goes. Comes in before the chorus, okay? So it ties this verse riff we just learned into the chorus before they start singing Jamie's Crying. So we're gonna start on an F sharp, 2nd fret, low string, and then an open A, and then 4-2. And then on the D string, 4, then an A chord. So slowly. goes. So that riff one more time before we go in the chorus is. All right. And here's how the chorus differs. It's got this. It's got that riff in there that we got to squeeze in. So the chorus riff is like the verse. What I'm doing is I'm on the A string and I'm up on the 7th fret and I go down to the 5th fret. I put a little bend. Sometimes I think he does a pinch harmonic. So you take the fat of your thumb against the tip of the pick, just barely put the tip of the pick next to the thumb, the fat of your thumb, and kind of chirp the string with it. So. So then there's a bridge part where he sings, I want to send her a letter. She wants to send him a letter to try to make herself feel better, right? So what he's doing there is he's doing an A to a D. He's got this A pedal tone. So this A, this low A, rings out through those chords. So this is like an A chord like this, but we're just playing these middle strings in the on the D, G, and the B string on the 7, 6, and 5 with a low A, and then we're going to slide up to which is 7 on the G string and 9 on the D string. Just does that during that bridge. You can also play A and do like this D shape. As I've listened to it, it does sound like he's up here. Then he goes back into the chorus. Okay, and then there's this little thing. It's kind of like another bridge. And what does he sing in that part? She needs a little more than a one-night stand. That part, it's a C-sharp minor. And he rolls back real quietly. And so it's almost, it's very clean. And he goes up to a D. And he goes back down to a C-sharp. To an F-sharp. I think it's a minor, might be a minor, maybe a major. He really only plays the bottom three strings on that F sharp. I want to say it's a minor, but and then he goes up to this very end to an E. And then he goes. Which is just on the B string, it's a 10, and then 9, and then the G string on 9. Like you're going. So the very end of that little bridge sequence. Sorry. One nice stand. You can play your E down here. You can also do it up here. Then it's the guitar solo. you want to consider that a guitar solo. So what he does is he takes that. So what I'm doing there is I'm kind of combining that riff from the chorus with this guitar solo. So he's going open E and B. And then he slides up. Eddie loved major thirds. They were really juicy. So it's the B and the G string. And it goes up to the ninth fret. I'm gonna slide up twice. And then go down onto the seventh fret and put a little bit of a tremolo on it. All right, so that's that middle solo part. And it goes back into the. At the very end, I think it does this. And then we've got the outro solo. And the outro solo starts up here. It goes. And it goes. So it's slightly different than the very beginning. He's going to be up way up here on the 19th and 17th fret on the G and the B string. Okay? And then he's gonna go. Sorry. So he's taking this blues lick that, you know, that thing. So it's the 16th. Bend it up a whole step. And then hit the 17th fret with your pinky. And bend it back down. So it starts off, and then just like the beginning, 15th and 17th, go down, so I hope Jamie's not crying anymore and that this was helpful. You enjoyed the lesson. If you did, please consider subscribing, comment below, and as always, have a great day. Peace out.